What's going on, people? Welcome back to another video. My name is Hugh Izzy, and you're watching the internet's favourite late night football show, the internet's favourite football phone-in, coming to you live all the way from Fraud Gang headquarters. It is your fraud father himself, back up in this Omari Bischoff. We go again, my sons, my sisters. Welcome back to Late Night Fraudulence. We have been absent for a week now. A week starving the fraud gang of Late Night Fraudulencia. My sons, I've been super, super busy, but gang, gang, I see you. I see you, and the hype is real in the chat. Wow. Fraud gang in the building. We are truly global. Let me know exactly where you're watching from. We'll do some global gang shout outs. And join me by raising your espresso emojis and toasting as we journey deep, deep, deep inside. And toast to fraudulent free living. My sons, fraudulent free living. Let me know in the comments below or in the chat if you're watching live and exclusive. Who's on Fraud Watch today? And if you do want to get involved tonight, once more, of course, we do have the internet's favourite football phone-in. The phone-in for the late night true baller. The late night phone-in for the real football fan. Get your football fan selves into the Discord. The links are in the description box below. Join the queue. Get in and have your say. Let's have a chinwag about your club. Maybe you're an Arsenal fan and you need to talk about referees. Oh, I'm tired of talking about referees, bros. We need to talk about the football. We will be talking about both tonight, though, my sons. Maybe you're a Manchester United fan and you're just gassed off of life. They say, how do you sleep after drinking this Nicaraguan, it's actually Ethiopian, coffee today? Sleep is the cousin of death, my fraudulent friends. Spurs fans, whilst we're talking about death and spiralling and depreciation, lying down, taking it like a silence. You've disappeared. Where are you? Talk to me. Let's have a chin wag. Whichever club you support, wherever you're watching from, this is the People's Show, where your voice gets heard. Make sure you are subscribed to the channel if you're new. And drop the video a damn like if you breathe oxygen. But for now, we're going to get to it. Let's do some shout-outs. We have got Dublin in the building. We have got the Falkland Islands, Namibia, Sunderland. Why did they do it like that? Vancouver, incredible. Sunny Scotland. Reading, double down on the Reading. Dublin, Ireland, lots of Ireland in the building. New Zealand, New Jersey, New Hampton. Incredible scenes of glorious emotion. The scaffolding has been pulled down, my young Purdian. My young Purdian friend, what's this? I've got a new watch. We got a present for birthday. Apple Watch. Beautiful. Makes lots of noises. Don't know how to turn it off. Boomer, they said. Well, I never. We've got plenty to be talking about tonight. And we are going to crack straight into it. If you have got anything you want to say, make sure you get your comments and questions in. I'll go through as many of them as possible. Before we go to the phone lines, we will, however, today be starting with this, because I'm just wondering, why is this ton here tweeting? Why is Hector Bellerin tweeting at this godforsaken hour, 9:33, straight after the game? I mean, the game finishes at like 9:28, so you're genuinely in the changing room. Tweeting pictures. Captain of my club. Big old Arsenal Football Club. Yeah? It's actually crazy. It is actually crazy. I mean, where am I? Where have I disappeared to? I've gone. Let's just switch over here. What's going on? There we go. See, I'm looking at this picture now. It makes me wonder, right? things were going swimmingly, weren't they? So, have you ever actually had a situation in your life where everything is just going so well, or too well? Everything is falling into place. You know what I mean? That's where I felt like we were with Arsenal. No worries. The kids are coming through. Yeah? We're sending them to school. They're coming back with A's, recommendations. Everything falling into place. Mercenaries are leaving the club. The deadwood is getting flogged, sold, scrapped, trashed, put out for the rubbish, the bin men. Yeah? Anyone come and collect it. People are collecting it. They're taking the rubbish. It's all going a little bit too well. And so we come to today. Today, oh wow, incredible scenes. I mean, Hector, bro, you're the captain of my fucking club. You're the captain of my club, the skipper. And you're tweeting this. And this is bad, bro. This is weak sauce. This is weak sauce. This is flower man shit, yeah? Real dons don't tweet, yeah? After football games. Basically, if you don't win or you're not scoring hat, don't tweet. Especially when within two clicks of you posting pictures of this as if there's some kind of secret coalition going on. I'm clicking and seeing this. Yeah? No. You're not thinking. You're not thinking straight. You're actually hurting my head, right? Oh, good God. Oh, good God. Oh, wow. I'm going to try and be composed about this, but today will be forever known to me as the Shkodran Mustafi / Sayyad Kolasinac testimonial / memorial. How much banter can we squeeze into one football match? Like I said, you're hurting my head. You're hurting my head. Let me just gather my thoughts for a second, right? Because we signed a new goalkeeper. This is my club, right? This is my club. Let me just tell you about my football club. My football club are like this, right? We signed a new goalkeeper. He's injured himself in training. Yeah? 3 days at the club. 3 days at the club and he's injured. It's actually very, very funny. It's very comedic. It's comedic stuff. Comedy club. Almost banter era stuff. We've bought an emergency goalkeeper in for the very low prices of 4 newspapers and a pint of milk. Yeah, one game in we find out he can't catch. No, hold on, sorry. And now I'm looking at you, Leno, bro, like wow. What is going on here? Basketball dons, yeah? Basketball dons. What's this? You've been watching the NBA as well? I watch it too. Mad. It's actually crazy. You've been watching too much. Did you play 2K? You're playing 2K live. What's going on? 3-game ban or a 1-game ban, which I'm not clear. The Premier League, I think, has said 1. But it doesn't really matter. Are you skunked? Huh? Truly, Bants, truly. And you know, the worst thing about this is I feel like we've genuinely thrown this game. We had this in the bag, lads. 47th minute. You've got 3 seconds to last. And, I mean, what a game to throw as well. A Wolves side who desperately needed a win. They could not get a win for love nor money. The fans have been thinking about sacking the manager. And who is there? The knight in shining armour to save this Don. Oh, wow. And it's very sad. It's sad scenes because it started so well, didn't it, really? Nicola Pepe, magical stuff. A beautiful bit of play where he's nutmegged two absolute frauds, curled it into the top corner with the weaker foot. You love to see it. my club. Look, I want to be positive, right? And I'm not going to do this referee thing, but we are going to have to talk about the referees. I say I'm not going to do it. I am doing it. Are we doing it? We're actually going to do it. The problems with the game today aren't really about the footballers on the pitch for Arsenal Football Club, as far as I'm concerned. I don't want to see tweets and all that, but really and truly, they were quite good, Arsenal. They were quite good up until that counter-attack where... good God. I'm sorry to say this, but it kind of goes without saying, right? VAR, referees, we've got to talk about it. Saka's situation with Bolly is not a penalty. It's not a penalty, no? Saka gets to the ball first. Clearly, I'm looking at it in my own eyes. I've looked at it 200 times, bro. Yeah? There are situations which are very similar where Arsenal are being penalised or losing out. And... it is justifiable. It's justifiable, the decisions they're making. Somehow, some way, you're giving me the excuse, but that doesn't run for other clubs. Make no mistake about it. David Luiz is being subjected, especially in punditry right now, to recency bias and also some kind of like prejudice because of his track record. Now, I'm not suggesting that the guy is... not at fault, he's out of position in the first place, but let's be honest, lads, we all know, if we're like football dons, you understand he wasn't trying to foul him. Plus, it's actually worse than that. It's actually worse than that, bro. There's not a red card, it's not a penalty, and it's a dive to make it worse. You're a big fucking man. You're 6'6" and you dive into the floor like a little... oh, I swear down. Listen, so dizzy. Oh, you're kicking the ground. I saw it. Don't try it, you little fucking fraud. Listen, you're on fraud watch. What's his name? William Jose. Half your name is definitely fraudulent. That's for sure. You got to credit Matinho for the strike. The goal is... that is a wonderful strike. I'm not going to lie. You've got to congratulate a player like that. You've got to celebrate, obviously, with your... what's this? Sorry, what's going on here? Hold on. What is this? Rose? What's going on here? Look, right, look, I don't mind you saying well done, but come on, hold it down a little bit. Oh, wow, you love to see it. It really is winding Arsenal fans up. But to me, you shouldn't need the referee. Yes, it's one hell of a hit. Yes, it's one hell of a goal, but we're talking about referees again. And that is... where we're going to have to go to for the Manchester United game as well. It brings us actually very nicely on to the Manchester United game. Edinson Cavani. And a whole fucking plethora of other players also scoring. 9-0. Bloody hell. Solskjaer's mighty roaring, rip-roaring Reds. 9. Smashing 9. Past a sad, sorry Southampton, stripped of all sense of secure, whatever. It's happened again. It's actually really annoying because now the pundits have an excuse to go, well, it's happened to them at Leicester, and I'm sick of hearing about it. I cannot imagine how sick Southampton fans are hearing about that Leicester game. But it was record-equalling stuff from Manchester United today. And, you know, I'm old enough to remember when Manchester United beat Ipswich 9-0. I think Andy Cole scored 5 on the day, someone tell me. But that game in itself was very different. There weren't any red cards. for a start, and this game was flipped on its head after a few minutes and ruined as a contest. If you're talking about, you know, watching from a neutral perspective, it became who can score. They were lining up, and look, there's something to be said for the fact that they have beaten them by such an amount, but you know, I don't really know how much to judge this. It's such a massive advantage, and Southampton would have been up against it anyway. But that said, Mike Dean, yeah, back at it again with the nonsense. Mike Dean, I mean, this is part of this soap opera problem for me. It's almost like these referees want to be stars, and even after you've had the chance to watch the replays on the big old screen, I don't care if the game's over or not. It's not important. It's actually totally irrelevant when in the game this type of thing is happening. You've had the chance to watch it on a big old replay TV screen with your big fraudulent bald head, yeah? And you've actually got me very confused, because I'm here thinking that technology is supposed to help referees, not the VAR Don supposed to be helping out his mate, digging him out of a hole. When the whole world is watching, we can all see it. And, sorry, they're talking about letter of the law. I'm sick of hearing referees backing up other fucking referees with the letter of the law stuff. Why are you giving him a fucking red card? It's nonsense. Martial, I mean, yes, goals. Okay, well done. Congratulations. You're playing against nine men and all that, all right? Don't get too big for your boots, but really and truly, you are a disgrace. You are a bit of a disgrace, bro. You should have been booked for diving. Come on now. I don't actually understand why a striker wouldn't want to shoot from there. Like, are you that low on confidence, bro? Are you actually so sure? You're so convinced that you are shit that you would rather fall over than shoot? Mad. It's mad, but still, 9-0. 9-0, amazing, isn't it? Amazing. They scored 9 goals and Bruno still scored 1 from the penalty spot. He's a meme. It is fucking hilarious. And well done, well done. 2 assists on the day. Not his finest, if you ask me. But, you know, people will point to him because they love pointing to him. And he has got now 36 goal contributions in 36 Premier League games, which is... it speaks for itself, doesn't it? It is, it's changed the fortunes of the club. That said, my man of the match would have to be Luke Shaw. He is obviously integral to what United are doing, especially as I think he was taken off at half time, wasn't he? Yes, he was taken off at half-time. And this is where we've got to talk about the air. We've got to talk about Donny, bro. Some Manchester United fans are going to have to ring up. We've got to talk about the beaky bake. It is not really working out. And I'm not convinced at what I'm seeing so far when I'm seeing it. Let me know if you agree or not. But for me, even though they're on 9-0s, it is a questionable one. It is a questionable one. Luke Shaw, though, like I said, I would probably give my man of the match, unless you're giving it to VAR, who are consistently coming up with new ways to fuck teams over. And I guess, you know, awful refereeing is just it's like a byproduct of Premier League football nowadays, isn't it? This is why I brought this Wenger quote up before. Wenger calls for overhaul of system that produces elite English referees, saying that they were untouchable, and also laying into the fact that there are only 2 countries in European football who have professional, I think world football, who have professional referees. That is England and Italy, and there were no English referees going to the World Cup in 2018. And that speaks for itself, doesn't it? I think he was right all along. And they definitely had it in for him because he was so outspoken about it. And it is now normal service resuming, quite clearly. We've had a little blip, a mad year with lots of discrepancies and whatnot. But it goes without saying for me, the Premier League is like the best league in the world. But I tell you what, mate, I'm slowly but surely falling out of love with everything about it because of the drama that this VAR situation has created. Because the current system creates way more problems than it solves. Anyway, I don't want to start waffling. We have got a couple of other games that I'm going to briefly touch on, but I didn't actually watch any others apart from the Arsenal and the Manchester United game, so I can only give you thoughts on the score lines. And those are, or were, I should say, Sheffield United actually getting a third win of the season, which is fantastic news for Chris Wilder and gives them some kind of slim hope chance, I guess, of maybe pulling off Mission Impossible. It would be a massive ask, but three wins out of the last five is good going. Newcastle United, Manchester United and West Bromwich Albion, and that is a relegation clash of the titans, really. I have seen the goals. It looks like they are more confident from out wide, but I'll have to watch the game to give you a more detailed analytical point of view. That said, it's good to see them winning. West Brom and Sam Allardyce losing. Sorry, West Brom fans. What else have we had? Oh, and Newcastle. I have to say, from what I've seen, they looked like they were quite unlucky, actually, to lose to Crystal Palace. But set pieces and Cahill getting the 3 points for Roy Hodgson and Palace. And there's the Premier League table. We see Manchester City level with Manchester United on points, but they do have two games in hand, the next of which is away at Burnley. And Liverpool, even if they were to win, could only go to 43. So United are settled and secure in second place for now. Whilst at the bottom, we have Fulham 7 points off Brighton, with Leicester their next game, and that is a game in hand there as well. It's tight, and it is especially tight in and around, well, I guess, from like 5th to 13th. 5th to 14th, you're talking, what is that, 6 points, wow. 5th to 13th, 6 points. So it really could change in a couple of game weeks, and there's still plenty to play for. As far as Arsenal fans go, it's not the end of the world. As far as Manchester United fans go, the title is not totally out of the question yet. Who knows? Can Manchester City, I mean, they seem to be everybody's favourites at this point, with just wins galore in the form sheet. But you just never know with this season. It has produced some ridiculous results, plenty of goal fests, and I can't actually remember anything like it, if I'm honest. It's different. I really do think this is morphing, actually, into a different sport altogether. We've got other news from around the world. I have seen plenty of the comments and questions coming through. I'm going to get to the chats now. Super chats have been flying in. You're all massively appreciated, everybody who's joined us, and you will get your chance to have your say in the latest of nightest of fraudulent phone-ins as we move over to the Discord. Get into the Discord by using the links in the description box below. Join in the queue. One of the moderators will show you the way. Show you the way. You will be shown the ways of the true warriors. Edinson, fraud source, simple tapping headers. Oh dear. I wish my club could score 5 goals, never mind 9 goals in a game, but will they be able to win the Premier League? That much is questionable. It's still up in the air, isn't it, really? And we're going to have plenty of frauds in the queue already as we move over. My sons, my fraudulent friends, thank you so much for joining me. If you would do me the honour of smashing the hell out of the like button, that would be massively appreciated. I don't know if you know how this works, but it's quite simple. If we get to 1,000 likes within the hour, we go for the hour. We get to 2,000, we go for 2 hours. If you want me here for 6 hours, it's 6,000 likes. It's that simple. I'm actually a bit of a slut. I'm a like slut. I will twerk for likes. You ready for some? No, I can't do that. No. Okay. I can't twerk anyway. Come on, I'll be serious. I'm a man. Yeah? I'm a real man. Real Don. Yeah? Real Dons don't twerk. Okay. We're drifting. Coffee. Need to slow down on that coffee, bro. Okay. Ollie Taylor says, Fraud Lord, Thanks for all the great content you're putting out. You don't understand how much it means to us in these turbulent times. My sons, we're all we've got, people. And I hope you are looking after each other. Actually, let me just do a little thing for you, Ollie. It's a difficult time, this. I'm not even going to pretend. You know, there are moments where I struggle for, I don't know, motivation, purpose, you know. And if especially I don't get the results that I want from the work that I do put in, it really is demoralizing. So you can, when you're on your own a lot of the time, slip into like a dark hole. Just stay strong. Just know that time is a healer. And I will be doing as many videos as I possibly can, well, of decent quality. Filming the podcast again tomorrow. Yeah, look, try the podcast as well. I know it's not for everyone, or at least the titles make you think that it's not for everyone, but it's just me and my mates having a chat, so it's a laugh. We talk about all sorts, and especially fun is replying to the relationship emails that we've been getting sent. So yeah, I recommend trying it out anyway if you are looking for something else to fill the time. They're like an hour long, just a bit, 45 minutes to an hour long. The links to that, again, are in the description box below, or at least the Instagram is, and you'll find all the links on there. Anyway, Ollie, stay strong. We'll get through it together, mate. Evan McGee says, unban me on Discord. Mate, I've banned you, and that means you did something fraudulent. Yeah, you're on Fraud Watch. I will think about it. If you can explain why you've been banned, because I've got no recollection whatsoever, I ban people kind of on the whim, I'm not going to lie. If you step out of line, you get banned. Yeah, I see you in here all the time, but you are a bit of a loose cannon, bro. I'm not going to lie. Your tongue is a little bit like a, you know, like a little gunshot pistol injection of poison occasionally. So... You're on Fraud Watch. Let me know why I've banned you and you might get let off. DJ, maybe you can tell me as well. DJ is actually here. Much love to all the frauds in the chat, especially the moderators, DJ, Harry Haas. I see Noah Wheeler, Paul, all the Dons who are fraud gang members. Oh, look at that. Evan McGee, you trying to buy your way into freedom. That's what do we think? Let's vote in the chat. Let's vote. Evan McGee, shall we free him or shall we keep him banged up? Because I think he's banged to rights. Yeah? I think you're banged to rights, Evan. I'm not going to lie. You're looking guilty right now. You know when a guy buys his missus flowers out of the blue, randomly? Huh? What do you mean? Huh? What? What? No. What have you been up to? No. It's looking a little bit suspect, Evan. The Wellsian says, only 500 likes. Exercise those freeloading fraudulent thumbs, you frauds. Say it louder, Wellsian. Keegan Bailey says, that match today must have been written to crush Arsenal fans' hearts. Was rooting for you guys and couldn't believe those two red cards. Listen, I can totally understand how people are up in arms about David Luiz's red card. I totally understand. I don't think there was any malice or intention. Plus, I do actually believe that... Hugh, why are you so mad at Martial? Real Don's twerk? No, bro. Maybe from your generation they do. Maybe your generation on TikTok are twerking. Yeah? My Don's don't... Apart from tracksuit, yeah? Only tracksuit, the only Don that I know who's on TikTok. We stay on on real life TikTok, huh? Listen, I do think, however, that there is a case to say that this is the reason that Arsenal have not been, because with even with nine men, lads, we weren't totally getting dominated. This team are playing average now. They've scored through a dodgy penalty and a 35-yard screamer that the keeper should be saving because he can see it coming from fucking 4 miles away. Do me a favour. It's not like a domination effect. No,
No, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no more coffee. Oh, good God. That's why we're losing. Because this Bellend's running out of the... You are actually bang average, aren't you? People are overrating you because you did a couple of flashy saves for the camera. I can do that! Fucking hell. And I don't want to hear anyone going, oh, it's his first mistake he's made this season. No, it isn't. Do you actually watch football or just the fucking highlights? Are you watching Twitter for the scores? Do me a favor. Listen. Oh. How's my heart? And does my heart feel so bad? Can't you tell? I'm a mess. This club will damage you emotionally, psychologically scar you for life. Yeah? Hope dashed. Hope dashed. Hope dashed. No hope. Just dash, 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 dash. Yeah? Fuck you, know. Mad. Keegan Bailey. I actually got a message today on one of the YouTube videos saying that this guy thought it was fixed. And I was just like, is this where we are now? We're actually, I mean, maybe it is. Maybe it is. I watch NBA. Who watches NBA, right? Obviously, Bernd Leno. Yeah, that goes without saying, you fucking fraud. Who watches NBA, though, in all seriousness? Who can tell me, right, which game... I saw a game once, right? It was the most ridiculous game I've ever seen. It was the most fixed thing I've ever seen. I've never actually seen a sporting event that was more fixed than this fucking basketball game. Stephen Curry, which is the Golden State Warriors. Yeah, the Warriors. Okay. Warriors are playing LeBron's team, whoever the fuck that is. I can't remember who it was. It might have been Cavaliers, I want to say. Listen, this was a joke. I've never seen anything this fucking fraudulent in all my life. They cheated. The refs cheated. Calling fouls that were not fouls. And then it's the most blatant fixing of a game, a sporting event, I think I've ever seen. Now, I've said this for years on this channel, all things aside, right? All banter aside. If you understand business and you understand the importance of your primary profitable product, then you understand the importance of marketing that sufficiently. You push your biggest seller, right? Manchester United are England and the Premier League's biggest export. They are this fucking country's biggest export, lads. Wake up. Please smell the coffee. Where's my coffee gone? Yeah. It's normal service is resuming here, lads. I grew up with some madness. If you ever want to see fixing in the biggest game, when Reyes was kicked out of the country, he was fouled and kicked out of the country. This is the most blatantly, obviously fixed game of football I've ever seen in my life. Come on. Come on, bro. You don't need to be an Arsenal fan to agree with me. You could be a Manchester United fan and revel in the fact that everyone was on your side and you were allowed to kick 10 bells of shit out of the opposition. You were allowed to try and break a man's fucking legs and risk his whole career and his family's well-being. You were allowed to do that because you promote the moneymaker, yeah? And it is good for business for Manchester United to be up there. Come on now, bro. And I'm not saying for a second that today that red card initially, the first one, it wasn't a red card. That's a red card, bro. It's a red card all day. I feel sorry for the kid. What's the kid's name? I've forgotten his name already. Poor kid. I really feel for the kid, man. He's young, right? And the reason Southampton are even playing this kid, I'm pretty sure it's because of injuries. He's not supposed to be starting yet. He's not like a super talent. Jankovic, mate. He's not going to play for that team again for a while. I feel really sorry for him. That's bad. He is only young as well. How old is he? He's 19. Swiss kid. Oh, he's a mess. Legs all studs all up in the air. Absolute madness. But you have to kind of empathise because, look, he's thrown in at the deep end and... Well, look, he's got it all wrong. He's actually technically a little bit like haphazard, but regardless. Anyway, it ruined the game, right? You want to see entertaining stuff end to end. Who can beat who? Who can outthink who? Not a fucking
what was ultimately the refs. And because look, there's three dodgy goals in that, in those nine. I'm sorry, they score five or six, yes, 100%, but there's three dodgy goals in there. And look, you can't take anything away from them. They scored nine. There's a fucking record breaker. What a madness. Anyway, Keegan Bailey says that must have been written to crush Arsenal fans. Oh yeah, I was going to tell you about this comment here. The guy says the games are rigged. VAR is connected with in-play betting. I was like, what? Funny how Arsenal and Southampton's game both had two red cards, both had a goal disallowed. Refs and VAR control how many corners, free kicks, cards, etc., all of which involve in-play betting. They control the market. William Hill needs to take a close look at Deadpool betting. Look, I've got no idea what he's talking about, although there were a couple of things that I saw today where I was like, what the fuck is going on there? Are you seeing them giving throw-ins when it's a corner? Huh? What's going on? What? They've got fucking cameras and everything. Earplugs. They can talk to each other anyway and be like, no, mate. It's a throw-in. It's a corner. No. Come on. Corner. What are you talking about? Are we this fucking deficient, devoid of actual eyes? Are we blind? Huh? Or is this genuinely the most fixed thing ever? Oh, wow. These are distractions in life, lads, right? Football is a distraction. It's not real. It's okay. It is fake. It's do you know what I mean? It's like tossing a coin up in the air. All right. What does it actually mean? But are we really being hoodwinked? I feel a little bit like I've been mugged off today on several levels. anyway, John Hudson says, Josh Hudson, sorry, says, busy watching the Pompey game. Did I miss something? Yeah, probably did, yes. Zach Holmes says, awful refereeing for both games, but 9-0 to Manchester United, GGMU. DBX says his hand was offside. Yeah, look, I don't understand this anymore. I don't understand what they're doing to my fucking game. I swear down, what are you killing my game for? This is not it. This is geometry! Drawing these fucking lines. Nonsense. Talking about, the sleeve ends here. Hang on, what are you on about? What if I roll my sleeve up? Huh? What if I got a shorter... Oh, you're talking nonsense! None of this is making sense to me. I don't like the way we're... I don't like where we're going. I don't know where we've gone. Never. And why is it only in England that it's this bad? Anyway. Rohan Vias says, FA Cup was our only chance of getting Europa League... Martin says Arsenal's first half was our best half of the season, ? I'll read that again. Martin says Arsenal's first half, our best half of the season. I don't know why would you read a sentence and then say ? You fucking weirdo. Leno will be back, he says. Yeah, he'll be back, yeah. Because what are we like? Obviously he'll be back, yeah. We're a football club, but we want NBA dons playing in goal, yeah. Do you not know the laws of the game? Huh? At your big old age? Oh, he's punching it out of the area. What's this? No. Am I fucking seeing things? Or are you smoking the fucking street's hardest yam? Which one is it? I actually can't believe it because like you said, who was it? Martin. That was Arsenal's, or one of Arsenal's, best halves of the season. Attacking intent from the get-go. Saka having three shots within the first 8 minutes. Hit the post with one. Had a disallowed goal. We looked like we were going at them. Confident on the ball. I mean, you want to have a fucking word with yourself, mate. Going home to your fucking fancy bird and sitting in your mansion when you actually... What are you doing? Dancing out of the area. Skipping. He's skipping. Oh, handball. Oh, wow. I've seen it all. Seen it all. Seen it actually all.
Fuck it. Mate. Okay, super chats. Prince Kwayama says, Hugh, please can you watch Peter Walton, former referee's opinion on the David Luiz penalty? It's one of the worst things I've heard a ref say. Peter Walton's view, you'll have to link it to me. I will have a look and see if anything comes up. Oh, here we go. Let's have a look and see what this is. Craig Pawson, you are the biggest fraud out. Do you actually just want the fucking fame? Is that what... No, do you know what's funny? Do you know what I've started to notice that's really pissing me off? Yeah? You can demonetize this video as well, you little prick. I don't give a damn. Yeah? Fuck's sake. Fuck it. You see you, yeah? You see you. And this fucking referee, he's doing it a lot. It's not just him. Have you noticed how they take 4 seconds to check Arsenal's VAR checks? When they checked Saka, it took 5 seconds and one angle. When it's us, on the flip side, we're doing up every camera angle in the stadium. Yeah? We're checking the toilet cameras to see if we can see if we've clipped him. You're taking a mick, 20-minute checks, 5-minute checks. Listen, you, yeah? Paulson. You're a shocking referee. You should be ashamed of your level. You're not even conference level. That's a fact. And the only thing, that's stopping me from really going in is the fact that I know my mum's watching this video. You're lucky. You're real, real lucky. But trust me, I'll get you on Instagram because she doesn't use it, yeah? You fucking fraud. David Luiz... I feel really sorry for him today because what's happened is his reputation has preceded him and you've got people judging him for his previous. That's not right. He's been good recently and although he was out of position, he tried to make a recovery and he's backed out. What's happened is, you little fucking bitch boy, you've dropped like a fucking sack of potatoes. You soft little... William Jose. I should have known from that fucking name. I should have known. Biggest fraud in... Where is that? Midlands. Middle of nowhere. Yeah? You're in the middle of nowhere. Middle of nowhere, mate. Who lives in fucking... Who lives in the Midlands? Really? I mean, apart from, like, millions of people. Fucking hell. Okay. Sorry, lads. Sorry. Peter Walton. Fucking hell. Do you really want me to watch Peter Walton so I can go in another bald ref? Are you serious? You're not bald yet, but you will be. Trust me. And when you are, oh, I'm tweeting all the picks. All the angles. Oh, should we VAR that and check if he's lost another shred? He's got 3 strands of hair left. Yeah, your fucking day's coming soon, mate. Okay. So, this is amazing. This is amazing. Thank you so much for sending this. Walton. Another fucking fraud backing up the actual frauds. Yeah? The Frauds Association being backed up. And we're paying... This is the muggiest little... Oh, it's unreal, actually. It's unreal. I've just clocked it, right? We're the mugs. We are the mugs. We're getting mugged off, lads. We are the mugs. We're paying through the nose, yeah? For Sky Sports and BT Sport. Shocking punditry, by the way. Can we... Do you have anyone else apart from Carragher and Neville? Is there anyone else... No one else, just 2 dons that can talk about football. Oh, unbelievable. I mean, it would be fantastic to get someone else's opinion, but no, cool. Okay, let's just go with those two. Now we're doing BT Sport and all these dons. Who are these fucking dons, these nobodies you've got on? Bang average fucking footballers who can't even string a sentence together. Please, please, send them on a fucking elocution course. Please. What I'm seeing as well is this referee. Who's this referee they've got in a fucking hut? They're keeping him in a little box. Like it's some kind of VAR room. Like he's not going to be protecting his fellow brethren. Please wake up, lads. Listen to what this Don's saying. Despite admitting that David Luiz didn't mean to foul Jose, Walton explained why the red card decision was correct. Intent doesn't come into the law because you can't read what's in a player's mind. Yeah? So you're going by his actions, and his actions there were rather careless.
In terms of bringing the player down, yes, he doesn't make an attempt on the ball. That's the important thing. So basically, what they're trying to say is, had he actually made a swipe,
yeah,
of the guy's legs, had he actually cleaned him out with a fucking clothesline, it's a yellow. It's only a yellow, lads. Yeah? But because he's trying to get out of the way, because as far as I can see, there's no fucking visible contact, because this fucking 6'5" Don wants to fall on the ground like a sack of shit, we're giving him a red. And a pen! And a fucking pen! Oh! Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. I mean, you could not write this. You could not write this. Because he hasn't made an attempt on the ball, and the ball is not within playing distance, that becomes a red card. And Craig Pawson has no opportunity to give him a yellow. It has to be a red card and a penalty. If I could just add, that's the third time I think David Luiz has been sent off for a similar offence. So you could say players should learn and understand.
Oh, good God.
Let's go to the phone lines before I have a nervous breakdown. Evan McGee. Hopefully someone will unban you. He says, here's your flowers. Michael Melrose says, I'm not saying there weren't horrible calls made, but Cavani should have had a penalty. His foot was on the line. I think he had a toe on the line. I think you're right. Yeah, I would go with that. But, you know, it's by the by, really. Is 9 not enough? You're not had enough, no? You want more, yeah? Have some more. Have some more, then, you greedy fucker. I mean, sorry. Rohan Vias says, the referee would be killed if he did this in the Turkish league. I mean, that's a bit far, but Jake Kirby says, I think we got to see a glimpse of what Arteta wants out of the team in the first 45. Looking forward to seeing what he can do with more of his own signings. I agree with that. I thought there were some really promising signs in the first half. However, Arsenal have done themselves out of it, and we are where we are. And where we are is fucking 10th in the league again, I think. It is indeed. And Leeds have got 2 games in hand and they're 2 points behind. Southampton have got a game in hand and they're a point behind. It's potentially back to where we were a minute ago, and I don't think we're going to get out of mid-table, mate. But regardless, this season is a write-off. It looks like it could be all about the summer. Hey, a summer of disappointment. Judgment Summer 45. Anyway, we're going to move over to the phone lines. If you are new to the stream, much love for joining me and us, the fraud gang in the building, the global fraud gang in the building, for late night fraudulence. If you could do me the honour of smashing the hell out of the like button and subscribing to the channel if you are new, it would be massively appreciated. We are here on a regular basis with all the football content that you need. And it is also the place where you get to have your say. Let's go over to the Discord now and invite our first caller onto the show. It is going to be, I think, a Manchester United fan whose name is 21 is coming. I'm giving him a little introduction so that he can get himself ready. If you are in the call queue, please do be ready. If you want to get involved in the calls, all you've got to do is click on the link in the description box below, get in the Discord, join the queue, and have your say. 21 is coming. You are now live and exclusive on Late Night Fraudulence. What's your name? Where you're calling from? Hello?
Hi, hello.
Hello, mate. How are you doing? Yes, I can hear you loud and clear, mate. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Hey, I'm Arya. I'm from the United States.
Much love for getting involved, bro. What do you want to talk about tonight?
United.
Okay, tell me what's on your mind then. Manchester United flying with a 9-0 victory. Was it a fraudulent win, or is this title race back on?
Okay, Tyler, to be honest, I don't think United fans...
No, you're stuttering. You're stuttering already, mate. You're stuttering. You're worried. You're not really convinced. You're not convinced. Is it a fraudulent challenge that we're looking at here, or is there something?
No, I think the win was convincing enough. The red card, the first red card was for sure a red, 100% a red. Second one, even Martial and Ole said that it was not a red, so... I'm not going to comment anything on the second red. So the second was definitely
No, hold on a second. That's not how this works, mate. This is Late Night Fraudulence, where we call out frauds and we free the realness, the truth. And the hard-hitting home truths are that Anthony Martial dived for that second penalty, didn't he?
No, that was not a dive. He clearly shoved him. So I think that was a pen, but not a red. It was similar to the David Lewis.
Sorry. Shoved him? What do you mean?
Yeah, he did. He did shove him.
No, I think you must be watching a different game. This is confusing. Okay, so...
Nah, man, come on. He did. He had this hand in... there's just no way. And you know, like, penalties have been given before for similar instances.
Yes, indeed. Probably to Manchester United. Bruno seems to be getting most of them.
No. I mean, it was dodgy, but that was definitely not a... Not a dive.
Not a penalty. It was dodgy. Not a penalty or a red card. Unbelievable. The audacity. I cannot believe it. Anyway, are you serious about United's hopes this season, or are you thinking that top four is enough?
No, I think, of course, I just want United to challenge for the title. To be honest, I think Ole is 1 year early. No United fan was expecting us to challenge for the title this season. We were just like, you know, close the gap on Man City and Liverpool, but I think we're actually challenging for the title, some would say. I don't think we will win it. City and Liverpool, they both have better players than us, that's for sure. And we're in there, but I still think that City are favorites. But you have to be guessed as a United fan, because I think, you know, we have been doing great, and I'm loving life as a United fan.
I mean, that leaves a foul taste in my mouth, but I'm happy for you. I'm happy that it's going so well. It's funny, were you a Manchester United fan who said Ole Gunnar Solskjaer wasn't the one? Do you think that he actually has a long-term future at the club?
Oh, this is my first time on the show, so I don't know who said that, but to be honest, he needs to win a trophy before we say that, but he has my full backing, and... there's definitely progress. Like, what he has done to Luke Shaw, what he has done to, you know, what he's done with Anthony Martial as well. Some would say he's a bit fraudulent, but I think Martial, his link-up play is absolutely fantastic. And the hold-up play is also pretty fantastic. So I would say there's a lot of progress, a lot of improvement, but there's still some way to go.
Okay, fantastic talking to you, bro. Absolute pleasure having you on the show. I hope you're calling again when things aren't going so well, because you sound a little bit happy for my liking tonight, but much love for getting involved.
By the way, one more thing.
Yes.
Just before I go, the David Luiz red card, I have this tweet on my Twitter, and it was not a red. Like, even when you look up at the rule book, it clearly is not a red.
Yeah, it's the double jeopardy rule should be coming into play, I think. But yes, thanks for that. Nice little token gesture on his way out the door. Absolute frauds, top of the table, mugging Arsenal fans off, saying, it wasn't a red, don't worry yourself. 9-0! Fucking hell, incredible scenes. You'd love to see it. Who's going to be next on that list? We are going to move to Mr... Martinelli next up. Martinelli, you are going to be up next. Get yourself ready. Much love to everyone who is joining us in the stream on this glorious night. A record equaling night for Manchester United fans who have stayed in the second place in the table and currently hold the second place trophy, which they are parading around social media with barefaced cheek. Now, Martinelli, much love to your mother for getting involved. What is your name and where you're calling from?
Hello.
Hello, mate. How you doing?
Hey, Hugh. It's my second time on the show. My name is Mike.
Hey, Mike. How's life?
From New Jersey, man. I'm good, man. Snow's going crazy.
The snow's going crazy. Well, it's
yeah, man.
It's cold and dark in these streets, and
but yeah. So I'm here to talk about the corruption.
Okay, corruption. Is this a conspiracy theory or a football corruption?
I mean, based on what I've seen, like from the past, like 4 or 5 seasons, I'm not sure what's going on, man. Like, I feel like there's so many blatant decisions that go against us that are clear. Like, it's over and over again. We see the same things. Like, the referees, man. Like, Like, what's going on? Like, I don't understand.
I'm not sure I understand either. Some very questionable decisions we have seen today and in general this season. I think VAR was meant to solve a lot of problems. It's actually
what's the point of VAR if it's not overturning clearly decisions like what happened today? And again, with that double jeopardy rule, I don't understand how is that if and at all, right? If there was contact, how is that not at most a yellow? How is that a straight red card?
Right now,
and it's the second time it happens too. If you remember in the Chelsea game last year when Mustafi made that bad back pass and then David Luiz came in and tried to challenge for the ball, it's the same situation, goes for the ball and then he gets sent off even though they get a penalty, and that's punching us twice. And I'm a referee myself in the States here.
Ooh, okay.
So like and we've talked about this before, and we know that it's not a red. And by the new rules, we know this shouldn't be a double jeopardy. This shouldn't be a red card. It should just be a yellow card to caution the player, and then a penalty to punish the team.
Fraud gang, we've got a referee on the line. I'm feeling extremely uncomfortable. I might have to just hang up.
No, man.
Listen, the fact of the matter is, I think John Terry has actually replied to an Instagram post on David Luiz and the decision, and he actually says it's never a red card, it's double jeopardy. Anyone who's ever played the game can see Luiz never attempts to play the ball. He actually pulls out of the challenge, which means penalty but no red card. He says you obviously don't play and need to check the rules to whoever has given him stick. But that is the way that it's gone. And should Arsenal Football Club really be in a position where they're having to blame this?
I'm sure I know you saw the game. You were watching. We were clearly dominating the first half completely. Like we had all the chances. They barely had anything. I'm sure if that decision didn't happen, we definitely would have taken the 3 points. No question.
Well, I've just seen a comment in the chat, right, from a guy who actually, I'm not going to go in on you, I'm looking at you and I could. He's actually said, remember when you were saying City were not title contenders? No, bro. Oh, Robert Evans, I'm going to come for your neck in a minute. Right, listen, mate, Martinelli, Arsenal Football Club are going to let you down for the rest of your life. There'll be momentary blips where we actually give you a bit of, you know, real joy. Today wasn't one of them. We've had it stolen from under our noses, though, because Arteta seemed to have something going in the first half. Are you actually confident that he is the right man to take Arsenal forward and that they can get good business done in the summer?
I'm not blaming Arteta at all for our loss today. Not at all. That's not his fault. It was a stupid referee mistake, and then the game was gone from there. Like, it's not his fault. And I was always Arteta in, no matter what. Even the rough patch that we had before we put in Smith Rowe into our lineup, I was Arteta in. I knew that. I trust his philosophy, and I know he's the man to take us. And especially if we have a good summer this summer, we wouldn't have to rely on these referee decisions.
Okay, I hear you, mate. Much love for calling us in. You want to leave us with a hard hitting home truth?
I just want to tell all the United boys out there, you're not winning the league, mate.
Jeez, there it is. Much love to your mother for getting involved. Martinelli.
Thank you.
Huge fraudulence in the chat. If you want to get involved and have your say on the show, all you got to do is click the link in the description box below, click on the Discord, get in there and join the queue. We're going to move the conversation to a man who has Bernd Leno as his profile picture. Bernd Leno actually playing basketball outside the area as his profile picture. JB is up next. I'm wondering, are you an Arsenal fan, JB? Mate, you an Arsenal fan?
No. I am a Manchester United fan here.
Why have you got that picture as your profile picture?
Oh, it's just a bit of a laugh, isn't it, really?
Is that what Arsenal are to you, a bit of a laugh?
Well, I mean, after that game, I can't lie to you, I don't know what's going on. I don't know what's going on. What happened with the game?
No, don't do that. You know what happened with the game. You watched it, bro.
No. I couldn't. I was working.
Oh, you don't know what happened in the game.
I've seen the after clip. I've seen that.
He's phoned up for banter. Hold on, he's phoned up for banter. Okay, tell us, what team do you support, mate?
I support Manchester United.
Oh, for crying out loud. You would be called in tonight, wouldn't you? Of all the teams. Come on and talk to me. What do you want to? What have you called up tonight to say? You just won 9-0. Huh? You should be getting pissed or something, shouldn't you?
Nah. I can't, hear. I can't, you know. It's not time for that, okay? You know, okay, you're looking at Man City and they're about to go 6 points ahead.
Oh, so you realise that you're not going to win the league then? Is that what you're saying?
I'm not saying that. I've come to call in to say, I think there's a chance.
Well, there's a chance I could get hit by a bus when I cross the road. But, you know, the likelihood is it's not going to happen because I'm going to look both ways.
Well, I mean, there's a likelihood that we're going to win the league because, you know, we're the best team in Manchester. But we're not going to talk about that.
Mate, you're not the best team in Manchester. And I like the fact that you led with that because you're definitely not the best team in the country. So, you love to see it. Delusionaldons.com. Listen, a good 9-0 win. What's going on with this fucking strand of hair? A good 9-0 win. Don't get too excited. You're playing against 9 men. Yeah, 8 men. And that's what, 10 men for 89 minutes. Realistically,
well, yeah,
you're losing to bottom of the table Sheffield United and you're out of the Champions League and you can't get past the semi-final and you're not going to win the league in the second and no one really remembers. Who came second in 2015? Quick, who was it? Quick. No, exactly. No one remembers. No one cares, bro. If you're not top, you're nowhere, all right? So enjoy the 9-0. It's a good win. It's good, but it's only 3 points. You only get 3 points, bro. You only get 3 points.
Should be a bonus point.
Oh, that would be interesting. Bonus points for 5 or more goals. Or every 3 goals a bonus point, maybe? Yeah.
Rugby style. It'd make it more interesting.
What is rugby style?
I think it's if you win a game by a certain amount of like points over another team, you get an extra point into the table.
Oh, that's ridiculous. This is why people don't watch these sports. They're ridiculous. What kind of nonsense is that? Okay, anyway.
You say that, right. You're talking about, you know, rugby style nonsense.
You would like rugby, wouldn't you? You sound like you're a northern lad.
Initially. I've had to move to the Midlands, yeah, which is unfortunate, but it is what it is.
Okay, he likes a bit of rugby, but then a lot of the teams in the Midlands and up north, they play kind of a rugby style football, don't they? In fact, United for a long time have played kind of a what is this type of football? Is this football?
It fluctuates from game to game, depending on if Martial starts, to be honest.
Oh, are you not a Martial fan then?
I think if you look at the difference in the way we played. If you look at the Liverpool game, we came out the gates strong. We were quick on the ball, a lot of good counter-attacking pace. But in the next game against Sheffield, Martial started. Look at the difference. Sloppy, giving away the ball in the final third, couldn't get anything going together. And I think this is what I've come on to say. We aren't going to win the league if we continue to play Anthony Martial while he's in this run of form. And I know he scored 2 goals today, but at the end of the day, 6-year-olds could finish some of the shots he's been putting in. I know that 1 goal was decent, but
he's on fraud watch. Right, Martial's on fraud watch. You heard it here first, JB.
Exactly.
Hit us with a hard hitting home truth before you leave.
VAR needs abolishing immediately, and I know you're going to say, you know, Manchester United, Man VAR United, whatever the bullshit is, but that Che Adams goal wasn't offside. I'm going to say it. I was watching the game. I was in the Discord, you know.
Yeah.
I was saying, this is absolutely ridiculous. The lad cannot finish with his hand. He can't put it in the goal with his hand. How can that be then counted as offside?
Yeah, it's.
And it happened before with Danny Ings as well.
Yeah. Well, I think we've seen quite a few unbelievable decisions. But we have also, in fairness, look, all banter aside, right, and you got to understand, I'm sure most of you do understand, that this is entertainment purposes, right, but what we saw tonight is sensational stuff. We've seen some mad goals, we've seen complete domination and a record equaling scoreline, that it is going to get fans gassed. And, you know, I think going into this season, a lot of people would have said United won't be anywhere near where they are now. So as much as, you know, it's easy to kind of, you know, mock the fact that they're not actually winning the league, the fact of the matter is they are right there or thereabouts after, what, 21 games. And who knows, man? This season is actually mad. It's mental. Anyone can beat anybody. So, I mean, look, I'd be super excited if I was a United fan. I would be super excited because with belief, you know, it's worth a go. And it's definitely progress as well.
Yeah, it's lovely to see because you can actually see the pieces coming together. Where under other managers, it seems like they just make a random signing that's a grab and attempt to make something happen, like Di Maria and Falcao and stuff like that. But it seems like now with the Ole like way of bringing in players, I know you're talking about Van de Beek earlier, but Paul Pogba's never going to stay at the club. I like to believe that if we win the league or if we have some sort of success this season, he might stay, but he's never going to stay. And Van de Beek is always going to be the replacement for Paul Pogba.
Oh, well,
I don't know whether he will not be anywhere near as world-class as Paul Pogba can be, but he's obviously the replacement that they've got in early to get under, you know, under the wing of Solskjaer, Bruno, get him into the team, and eventually he will be the replacement.
I worry about that, mate, and I think you're going to have to, I think you will find pretty soon, and you'll have to come back to me on this one, but I think you'll find pretty soon that he's not the one. I'm almost convinced of it.
Oh, you need to be watching. You need to be watching some old games of him.
I'm not watching random clips against what Juventus 3 years ago when they were fucking bang average. No. Champions League little highlights. Okay, all right. I mean, no. We're studying the games, bro, and I'm looking at him, and he's not really. He's not doing it yet. However, plenty of time, and those are big shoes to fill anyway. So, like we said, it's progress for United, and you know they should be happy about what's happened tonight, despite the fact that there was a lot of nonsense going on. JB, listen, mate, much love for calling in.
Can I say one thing finally?
No, bye. He's gone. I have the power! Sorry. Don't ask me if you can say one more thing finally. Just say it. When people say to you, when the missus, she go, can I ask you a question? You just did. You've used it up and you can't ask me anymore. I'm busy. All right? Cool. Much love, Josh, for calling in. Massive, massive fraud. We're going to move the conversation hopefully to another club now. Let us know exactly how you're feeling about the games today in the comment section below. You can always get your questions in if you want me to answer them directly. You know how to do that. And we move. We're going to be talking to DePep210, who I'm going to presume is a Manchester United... No, what are you talking about? Are you fucking skunked? A Manchester City fan, DePep. DePep, you're live and exclusive on Late Night Fraudulence. Much love to your mother for getting involved. Hope you're doing well. How are you feeling about watching Manchester United winning 9-0 tonight?
Listen, I'm all right with that. Listen, they were down 10 men the whole game. I'm not taking that seriously. Yeah. Mm. Anyway, before we get on to United, I just want to get one thing sorted out. You put me on Fraud Watch a while ago.
Oh, did I? Why? What did you say?
Because
I put a lot of people on Fraud
Watch.
Let's just say
you got a bit rattled.
About what? About what?
About Ozil. Does that recall anything?
Oh, are you trying to say Ozil wouldn't get more assists than David Silva at City? Are you?
No, that's not what I said. I said
I will school you.
I said as a joke.
On national YouTube. Yeah.
No. I said as a joke that Ozil was a flop, and you got rattled.
Okay. All right. So you are on Fraud Watch.
You're the one who compared him to Silva, not me. You're the one who did that.
Okay. Hit me with it then, man. What's up?
Well, all right, okay. Well, I mean, first of all, Can you let the mods know that I'm taking off Fraud Watcher?
At the end of this phone call, the potential is there for you to clear your name. As it stands, you are a massive fraud. And what you're sounding massive.
Okay. Well, explain that then. Explain how I'm a fraud.
No. You're going to have to hit me first. You got to hit me. Hit me with it.
Well, all right then. Well, I mean, listen, City haven't even played yet. So when was the last time we spoke? I don't remember.
It was a while ago now. It's about a month ago, I reckon.
It is, yeah.
You've won every single game since we last spoke.
Listen, we won the last 12 games in all competitions. Mm. I'm calm.
Would you
I'm
want a medal? Watching...
Okay, Q, mate. I don't think Arsenal fans are the ones to banter right now. Come on, man.
No, yeah. That's all we're good for, mate. You're very wrong about that. That's all we've got.
I mean, to be fair, you're a bit of a banter club, you know.
Whoa, listen, mate. Club, let me just tell you something. Your club doesn't even fucking exist without my club. Do you understand that you have stolen the blueprint from my
here
club?
We go.
You started signing our top
already
place.
Starting yeah? to violate
without
team.
Manchester
right.
City, Arsenal are Manchester City. We're at the top, dominating world football. Yeah, playing beautiful, sumptuous stuff, dominating 85% possession, 14 shots from 2 yards out, tap-ins. Yeah? That's us. You stole it from us.
Bro.
You are our sons. Listen. That's what you are.
No, you're not.
Plastic
no,
sons.
You're not.
You got a few listen, credit cards. You got a few listen, credit cards. All right, cool.
Listen, Hugh, tell me. When was the last time you won the league? Just tell me.
Oh. Do you know what? If your dad gives you £100 pocket money a day and mine gives me £2.99 a week, yeah? You can't talk to me about what you can buy. You can buy whatever you want, except the Champions League. How are you going in the Champions League?
When was the last time you won the league? Answer that question.
How's the Champions League going for that ball fraud? Huh?
Bro, you didn't answer the question. You're dodging.
Go on. What is it? Ask me. Go on.
Well, listen, when was the last time you won the league? Just answer that question.
Fucking hell. I think it's like 17 years ago now. Fucking hell.
Flipping hell. I mean, wow. That's incredible. Your club. Oh, I actually feel bad for you. How far
you
Do
you know what? If you were in front of me right now, I'd throttle you.
Listen, I won't banter Arsenal too much. You know, I kind of do feel bad for Arsenal, I can't lie.
Okay, you know? Right. Manchester City have not won the league yet, my son, and what's actually beautiful to see, all my Manchester United fans in the chat, where the fuck are you at? Let's get those Bruno Cup tears out, yeah? Bruno Bucket tears. United are coming.
Bro,
you should be worried, because Manchester is still red, baby. It's still red.
No. Bro, I just heard you talking to JB, and you just said that Manchester isn't red. So what are you talking about?
I'm not seeing City winning 9-0, bro. I'm seeing City getting spanked. Who did you lose to? Leicester. How many? Five.
Don't start from that. We did bash. I know we bashed Burton 9-0 one time.
Burton.
That was a while ago. Listen.
Burton,
listen,
they're not even professionals. What are you talking about?
2 games in hand, top of the league. But I don't think that should even be banter.
Do you know what? The funny thing is, bro, you could be 18 points top of the league. It's not going to impress me. You're moving like a sheik walking into Tesco's. Yeah? You can buy the whole shop. It's not going to impress me, bro. This is good. It's good. I mean, I'm happy for you. Do you know what? I'm actually thankful for you because I could not bear to see... Either, I don't think, Liverpool or United winning it again. They are so loud, it's unbelievable. Fortunately, there's not many of you, yeah? So you're still quiet.
Oh, we're still taking digs. Listen, you cannot be violating Manchester City Football Club when Arsenal Football Club... Where are you in the league? I don't even know where you are.
No. Listen. My club has no fucking bearing on yours.
Oh my, you're 10th.
We are in a different... We're almost in different leagues, basically.
You're 13 points behind us, and we have 2 games in hand on you. So we could be 19 points ahead of you. How's that feel?
It feels like you're taking a mick. That's what it feels like. What have you called up to say before I hang up on your clart?
Huh? Right, okay. Well, I mean, there's not really much else to say, really, apart from that. much to say, is there? Because City are just flying. I can't really. Right. There's nothing to complain about. You know, it's our league to lose. Listen, quadruple. Just gonna put it out there.
Quadruple.
You know, I'm not saying it's gonna happen, but you know, we are the squad depth of our club is Pep, you know, last time I talked about Pep Guardiola a lot. Oh my God. What a manager this man is.
Do you know what's going to be funny? Do you know what's going to be funny? Is when these Dons decide they've had enough. We're packing up. We've had enough. You are going to be left in the mud.
Our owners are here to stay. Listen, our owners are here to stay.
Yeah, no one stays, bro. They all leave. Trust. They all leave.
They're not.
Yeah. Everything comes to an end.
Arsenal's pull has gone. Arsenal's pull as a club has gone. It's too late now. City are taking over. We're going to... Listen, if we win a Champions League...
It's fucking embarrassing that you haven't won a Champions League. Are you not actually embarrassed by the amount of money that you've spent and failed to win a...
Listen.
Bro, you lost to Tottenham.
Okay, you want to go there. Okay, then, here. Okay,
no, you're cancelled. No, that's it. I've just realised. You lost to Tottenham. You don't get a say anymore. Hang up. Fraud's gone. He's on Fraud Watch. DJ, put that down on Fraud Watch. I think he's from Stockport. He's definitely got to go on Fraud Watch. He is 100% the biggest fraud. He just called me up to say, when have you last won the league? City fans. Huh? City fans. You can't do that. It's ridiculous. Michael Melrose says, does this Don realise it took City 43 years to win their last league title? Arsenal have 13 and City have 6. This is from a Manchester United fan. Mihailo Milutinovic, my son. How much do you think staying in Highbury would have changed Arsenal's fortunes over the years? Did the cost of the new stadium cause most of your problems? Yes, indeed. I would say they are at the root of all the problems, if we're honest. The decision to chase money and not further the footballing quality or the aspirations of winning more when at the top really define the future of the club, definitely, for me. It's a very sad situation. Oh, dear. I've got new neighbours. I wonder how they're dealing with it. Okay, Anwar is next. Oh, wait a second. I know this fraud. Evan McGee, alive and exclusive on Late Night Fraud. And that's the biggest fraud, the loudest fraud in the chat.
Oh, man.
How you doing, mates?
Yeah, can you hear me right now?
I can hear you loud and clear. You are live and exclusive on Late Night Fraudulence. What are we here to talk about, bro?
That's what I feel, the real Don up in here. So, who is he in the house? Okay, so Arsenal, if any, like, referee is a referee, they know Arsenal rules, like, every pitch in America. Especially in California. Arsenal is, like, a top club. They're a top club everywhere. And there's no reason you guys shouldn't be a top four finishing club. So you guys like got a legit whiff of the title today. I saw it in your face. And then the come down must be so hard.
No, bro, that's not the whiff of the title. It's not. It's just the shock of being in the top half of the table. The top six, our names were in there. It was like, wow, that's how bad it's been. And I'm not actually thinking we're going to do anything really this season, but we definitely had it stolen from us today. However, for you, Manchester United fans, when you say Arsenal are a big club in California, what does that mean? There's loads of people wearing Arsenal shirts.
Oh, besides that, I mean, on the field, they get results. They have Arsenal clubs that are endorsed by Arsenal and they kick ass in the major tournaments.
Oh, like who?
Well, they play in Surf Cup, and Surf Cup is like where Landon Donovan came out of in San Diego. And Arsenal clubs are always like top finishers there.
Is that like academy players or that type of thing?
Yeah, they're like Flight One sort of youth.
Okay.
National player pool.
Okay, that is interesting. Look, talk to me about Manchester United. Do you think that you can actually go all the way this season? It's starting to look like you're going to be in the title race.
I think a big problem is Greenwood didn't score today. like, what the hell? And James was put in as a sort of a morale boosting move, which is cool. And, you know, like, all of our veterans are doing great. Zlatan, Kaku, bolstering, like, all of our fuck ups and just being like, hey, yeah, we're solid. The plan's working. We're a title contender. However, when we're on top, it feels like the old times. It doesn't feel like Mourinho or when, like, I don't know, even Moyes sort of had, like, he was second at one point during his takeover. Mm. Nothing felt, like, legitimate. This feels like a legitimate play, although Manchester City has a really tough next few fixtures, and then we play them on the 6th of March. So if they can get their shit together, they'll probably really kick our ass. But that'll decide if they can go clear that day, Manchester City will have the league. Well, it's whether or not Mourinho can keep his job.
But there's a long way to go yet. Plenty of drama in store. And plenty of calls for us to get through as well. Evan, you're a massive legend for calling us. You're off Fraud Watch, right, temporarily. You've got us a pardon for joining us. Yeah. Much love for getting involved. Hit us with one hard-hitting home truth before you leave us.
McTominay is going to be a GOAT.
Get this fraud off. Get this fraud. He's back on Fraud Watch. Absolutely unbelievable scenes. Wow, what have I just heard? Okay, then, we move the conversation on. Who's next up? We have got Arteta's Fraud General. Arteta's Fraud General, you're now live and exclusive on Late Night Fraudulence. Much love to your mother for getting involved. What's your name, where you're calling from?
Can you hear me?
Yes, mate, I can hear you loud and clear.
My name's Charlie.
Hello, Charlie.
From Washington.
Charlie from Washington. Washington. How you doing, mate?
How am I doing? Not good, you, not good.
Oh, what's the matter, mate? What's the matter? Talk to us.
Well, look at the title, man. Arteta's under 18 fraud generals, so you know who I'm supporting.
Arteta's under 18 fraud generals. What?
Oh, okay. Bad joke, but I'm an Arsenal fan, that's why.
Okay, and how are you feeling about things today, especially the Wolves game? Didn't go to plan, but, you know, there's been certain talk about controversy. David Luiz, referees. Is it that to blame, or was it more?
Okay. All right, listen, man, I'm just taking the piss. I'm not an Arsenal fan.
What? Okay, right.
Yo, mate, I'm a Manchester United fan. You've been taking the piss out of, dog.
No, bro. You're a bellend. Like, get the fuck off. Oh, biggest fraud out. Bellends. Bellends. Don't be a bellend, all right? It's really simple. In life, you can either be sound as fuck, yeah? Or you can be a fucking massive fraudulent bellend. A big, cheesy, salty, smelly bellend. Don't be that, yeah? Fucking hell. He said, no, bro. This is the realest football show out. Yeah? Don't be doing that ever again. Put that guy on Fraud Watch. Who is that? DJ? Put that guy on Fraud Watch. I want him locked up for life. That's a lifetime ban. Do you understand me, DJ? I know you can hear me, yeah? Lifetime, locked up, 28 years minimum. No parole possible, yeah? Parole board's all been sacked. Sorry, mate. Awful scenes, awful. 1 out of 10 for effort. 1 out of 10. You're sacked, yeah? We're going to move the conversation on, my fraudulent friends. Next up on that list, we are going to go to probably all new blue. All new blue. It is going to be your moment very shortly. Much love to everyone who has joined us so far and made the show what it is. No love to the biggest frauds out who are calling just to troll the biggest... The biggest inspiration to your fucking favourite football YouTuber, bro. Yeah. Pay homage. Respect yourself.
when you are in the presence. Yeah. Because I will not hesitate but to chop you off the block. Yeah. The block is ours. There's a gang here. Don't mess us around. Wasting our time. Massive fraud. All new blue. Sorry, mate. I kept you on hold there. Hello, mates. How you doing? What's your name? Where are you calling from?
I'm Harvey, and I'm a United fan.
Hello, Harvey. How you doing?
I'm doing good. I'm obviously buzzing about the result.
Yes. Good result. You would be 9-0. Not bad. Not bad. Can't complain, really, yeah. Can you?
Yeah, it's been a real... Obviously, can't go down to the games, which is annoying. But for the whole club, it's been amazing because... The academy, that is, it's doing really well. It's doing really well. We've got Joe Hugo. He scored like 14 goals in 14 games. And got like four braces and scored four goals against Liverpool. So, got a real good season going. But we keep on trying to play McTominay CDM, which is annoying me at the moment.
Okay, would you not rate the guy?
No, I think McTominay, if you play him box-to-box, he could... It could be like a class player, but he's not a starter, I don't think, for a top four side or a side he wants to challenge. But he can do a job, but box to box. But at CDM, he just doesn't perform like he should. But Ollie, that's my one problem. I love Ollie, and I'm not people were Ollie out at that Everton result, Pochettino in and everything. But he's done good every season. But McTominay he's just frustrating at CDM, but. He was lucky. We're lucky today that he didn't have to face EDM because obviously Southampton.
Mm.
But yeah, that's what I'm on it. One issue at United at the moment. Tommy at CDM.
All right, look, you got two games more played than Man City, and points are level, so potentially a 6-point gap with the way that they're going right now. Is title too far this season? And what would you be happy with at the end?
Oh, I'm happy with top four, but I think we could win the title. If City step up, but at the moment it's City's to win. Really, there's not much we just got to hope they drop points and we keep winning. But we got the perfect bounce back. It's like the perfect result we needed. Because we had a really bad week. Obviously at Arsenal 0-0. We needed to win that. And Sheffield United result was a disgrace.
Beautiful scenes. Not what people were expecting, and that is clearly going to give a lot of people the impression that it's not a serious title challenge. Where do you stand on Martial? I've had a few people calling up tonight and saying that they don't really rate the guy.
Yeah, people don't rate he reminds me of Firmino in a way, but he can when he gets into he's a very confidence player, I think. So last season he got 17 goals, and after lockdown, especially when we come back, when he starts scoring, he scores for fun, and he got 17 goals in the league, and got the same as Rashford. But yeah, but this season he just hasn't quite got into it, and that's the reason. But you know he's got racial abuse after the Sheffield United result, and you don't know how that will affect someone. Mm. Obviously, that's vile what the people did. So you never know who he's. You never know how that's affected his mental health and everything going into the game. But he got two goals, but he didn't look too happy when he scored the two goals, which is one thing I was worried about.
I mean, he doesn't look that happy that often, if I'm honest.
Yeah, he never looks happy.
But he's got two goals tonight, and, well, that's actually doubled his tally for the season. Bloody hell. He's got four goals this season. Two of them came tonight. So four goals in 18 games. And that, I guess, is why people are... questioning him. He came for £50 million. How much did he come for? Was it £50 million?
Yeah, I think it was like 35 mil initially, but could rise to 50 mil, something like that.
79 goals in 265 games. It's not quite the ratio that people were expecting, I don't think. Anyhow, a big win. Like, regardless of whether you rate him or not, he did get two goals on the night, and that will do something for his confidence. Anyway, mate, listen, you want to hit us with a hard-hitting home truth before you leave?
21 is coming.
Oh, goddamn. Big call. Hope you get back on when there are bumps in the road. Much love for getting involved, bro. Absolute legend. Dear, oh dear, Manchester United fans. I don't think any of them really believe. It's quite sad, actually. You're actually level on points to the top of the table. And, yeah, it's probably not realistic. But belief. You got to believe. Otherwise, what chance have you got, you know? Dark Coco Boy says, who is the best youngster in your opinion? Saka, Foden or Mason Greenwood? They are three generational talents who could take England to the very top. I don't want to have to choose. I don't see why people are even comparing. They're three very different players. One is a striker who isn't even being played as a striker. One is already won the World Cup and is like Messi or just amazing with his control of the ball. And Saka is one of the most exciting talents in world football for me. So I don't have to choose. They're all great. Michael Melrose says, does this Don... Oh, yeah, we've read that already. Gaming Universe says, imagine Man City losing to Monaco in the Champions League. And Noah Stettler saying, oop, English footballing arrogance is the problem with referees, pundits and managers in this country. Same old stale ideas that don't work. Raging Twit, you're a massive legend, bro. I appreciate you. Adam Shuff says, how can people clown us for not winning the league when most people didn't predict we'd even finish top four? So many jealous dons about, it makes me laugh. Look, I think it's great United are back in the conversation, at least. It's where they belong. It's dumb not having them in there. And yeah, I'm into it. I'm into the competitive aspect of it. City, United, Liverpool, Chelsea will be in there. Of course, you've got Leicester making moves. Hopefully, Arsenal one day can sort their lives out and get back in the conversation. But United, regardless of whether you like them or not, are so well backed and they just have such a packed squad of players that they will be back. And the history of success, the foundations have been built for that to be ongoing. You know, they're well ahead of like everybody else. So as far as I'm concerned, it's only a matter of time until they do win the league. And maybe it will happen sooner rather than later. JB saying, was going to say well done on the podcast. You forward. Much love, JB. Absolute fraudulence from you, my friend. Sorry, I'm not sure how to pronounce that. Mr. Colm Corowen. I hope I said that right. He says, maybe I'm being too harsh, but I think Leno should have saved Matinho's shot. He got a hand to it. One could say fraudulent behaviour. Indeed, I do not rate this performance today from this guy in any shape, way, shape or form. The shot from 35 yards is an absolute joke that he's let that in. I'm sorry, you should not be letting that in. How much time do you need to see the ball? I mean, Partey is closing him down, but not soon enough. And yeah, look, it's a fantastic finish. I'm watching it now. It's a fantastic finish, but really and truly, that is never a goal. Never a goal. No way. Sacked in the morning. It's just a fucking mate. I don't want to be that guy that goes on about the signings and what we've done wrong in the window, but honestly, the worst thing about that is Matinho's goal is a cracker, but the Wolves' performance was a bang average one. Come at me. Next up on that list, we have got J.R. Bremner. J.R. Bremner, you're going to be live on Late Night Fraudulence very shortly. Much love to everyone who has tuned in so far tonight. Don't forget, we will be going we're going to be going for about 15 minutes unless we can get to 2,000 likes pretty sharp-ish. Anyhow, the next call is ready. J.R. Bremner, you're now live and exclusive on Late Night Fraudulence. Much love for getting involved. What do you want to talk about tonight, mate?
I want to kind of call out the amount of United fans you've had on tonight. Listen, I'm not as squeaky or as annoying as the last City fan, but if any United fan in this audience believes they're going to win the league in the next decade, they are having a laugh.
The next decade?
They're having the biggest laugh. I want Ole to stay there until he passes away. I want him there for forever. It is my favorite thing. Every kind of, for the last few years, this happens every season where Ole gets a bit of form going. The boys, they get a bit excited. United fans, they clown on other people on Twitter comments. and they believe they're going to do everything, and then they nosedive every season. I cannot believe I've heard today from multiple different people that they believe United are going to win the league, you know, like weeks after, you know, they've had terrible losses. They've lost to Sheffield United, drawn with an Arsenal team that weren't firing, and like barely scraped past Fulham 2 weeks ago. So like, I just cannot believe I'm hearing this. You won 9-0 against like a 10-man team, and it's happened to them before. And I just cannot believe it.
I would say you may well be onto something. Let me know in the chat what you think of this, because we have had lots of Manchester United fans on, but they are showing signs of actually being a little bit of a false horizon, if you will. They're blessed with such a mad amount of talent that it's easy to fall for it. They can definitely score goals, but I mean, recently, they've been slipping.
Even the talent thing, I mean, if you look at their squad, it's a lot of players who've just found form. I mean, Shaw was irrelevant 2 years ago and has suddenly found a little bit of form, and people are loving him for no reason. I mean, Slabhead's there.
Nah, he was good tonight. He was good tonight. He was.
I'll give that. I mean, I turned it off, obviously. As you can tell, I'm not from Manchester, and my dad's from Manchester and grew up a City fan, and I've been a City fan since a kid. I remember when we were shit, and I still kind of miss those days a bit, and I get all the stuff about fake fans. I 100% get it. I mean, I've been in the Etihad, I don't know, 100 times, and it still feels a bit empty to me. But, you know, it's, you know, the club's still in my heart, but I always still love when United fans get a bit of, they get a little bit excited. They just get a little bit excited. And then it all takes a dive. That's it. So, I mean, that's my favourite part of the league. United fans are delusional. I mean, if you want to talk about real football, Livingston FC up here in Scotland, we haven't lost in 15 games.
Wow, that's amazing.
I know.
What's going on up there?
Two draws against Celtic. Ever since our new manager took over, we haven't lost a single game. So we're high flying up here. So maybe we'll take Lingard on loan next season when he doesn't work out at West Ham.
That is an amazing record, Livingston. Where are you in the table then?
We're fifth, which, you know, in a table of like 16 teams, it's not exactly that important.
It's top six. It's top six for the playoffs, though, right?
Yeah, we could potentially get some European football, which, to our artificial pitch we have and our 5,000-seater stadium, will be amazing. I think maybe Arsenal might be joining us up here next season in the Europa League. We'll see what happens.
No. Listen, mate, yeah, Arsenal are joining the European Super League, mate. We're fucking the FA off. Apparently, what's going to happen is we're worried about getting frozen out of being a big club in the actual Premier League, so we're going to jump ship and just solidify a place where we legally can't get relegated.
I'm excited for the American-style league. Yeah, it's going to be terrible. Well, thanks for having me.
Pleasure having you on, man. Hope you call in again soon.
Yes.
And
cheers.
That have Livingston can continue that run. Have they got any decent players, Livingston, before you go?
I wouldn't quite go that far. We've got a big FA, our centre-back, who tried to do an overhead kick last game, apparently. We don't get highlights of the games. We only get audio because no one films them.
Oh, my God. But, really?
The Scottish League's pretty dire, man. It's unless you're Celtic or Rangers, you don't really get a lot of access to stuff.
Do you go to a lot of Livingston games then?
Yeah, I have done in my life. Obviously, they're not on at the moment.
So like, when you can go to the games, is there an option to watch the game as well, or is it just never on?
Well, they're usually not on TV, but I think they have their own channel that's like £20 a game if you want a pay-per-view.
Okay, wow.
It's awful. You know. Wow. Have a good night, Hugh.
Mate, pleasure having you on. Much love for getting involved. J.R. Bremner in the building. Manchester City fan here to tell Manchester United fans that they are talking absolute nonsense. Getting a little bit gassed. They need to get back in the boxes. You love to see it. You love. What is going on with this hair? We are looking like some kind of punk person. What? Yep. Okay. Much love to everyone who has shared the stream. You're all massively appreciated, and I'm going to be following a select few of you back now. What's this? Three quote tweets. Adam United, you're a huge fraud and I love you to bits. Titan Ori, what an absolute hero. Anthony, mate, you have worked your way into my little heart. It's actually a big heart, but it's a big cold stone heart. Cold stone made of ice cream. Marijan, much love for showing support. Boris Jugson. Bruno the Bargain and Mikey and TJ Lawless. Much love to your mothers for showing the Fraud Gang the support. The channel is only growing because of you, so I appreciate you. And I will strive to improve the quality of the content as well. I hope that you are entertained by this. If we can improve the show in any way, shape, or form, let me know in the comments. I'm always open to suggestion. And I am thinking about bringing the show forward a little bit, or at least doing an earlier version where maybe it's just a phone in. Again, let me know your thoughts. I know that not everyone can stay up this late, but I'm extremely nocturnal by nature, so this is a good hour for me. Much love to everyone who's liked the video as well and subscribed to the channel. You're all massively appreciated. I am going to love you and leave you for now, though. I'll tell you what, I'll do one more call. Fuck it, we'll do one more call. Josh Grant, you're now live and exclusive on Late Night Fraudulence, my friend. Josh, much love to your mother for getting involved. How you doing? Where you calling from? What club do you support?
Hello? Oh, sorry. Yeah.
Hello, mate. How you doing?
I'm good, thank you. I'm from Ipswich.
Ipswich, home of the previous nine nillers.
Yep, I know.
Oh,
but
dear.
I'm a diehard gooner.
Okay. Did you just give up on Ipswich at the beginning then?
Basically, I'm originally from London Colney.
Oh, okay.
So, right, grew up around near the training ground, and yeah.
Oh, that's great. A local Donny then. Well, it's sort of Watford, isn't it? Right. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Right. Okay. Talk to me then, man. What's on your mind?
I'm just annoyed. You know, I'm annoyed about what's happened today at this game against Wolves. You know.
I hear you. Is it the referees? Is it more than that?
It's referees. It's that. You know what? The thing that caught my eye today is at the end of that half, towards the end, the referee had the whistle in his mouth, and then he took it out and he let the play go on. What's that about? Mm. You know, that gives away a whole lot of fraudulence. I think a corruption. Yep. You know,
it was dodgy. I'm sorry to say that, but it was dodgy.
Definitely.
And I'm not one to look for. I'm actually the last person to look for excuses, because I think you've got ample opportunity in an hour and a half of football to make up for any mistakes that a ref's making. But this is taking the mix, to be honest.
Exactly. The most annoying thing was I was watching with a United fan. You know.
Oh dear.
Big up Ethan, I know, but he's. I'm sitting here. I was getting. I'm not lying. I was getting emotional. You know. I was getting up. I was getting a bit stressed out because I was like, we've done so well. David Luiz is, you know, he's put the performances in. He's earned the spot, but it's taken away from him from something that is just, it's pity, you know.
Well, it's unfortunate, but it is what it is. Arsenal, no points, and back into mid-table mediocrity. I mean, there were positives though. Pepe's goal was great.
That's got to be goal of the week, surely.
It was two nutmegs in a row, and curled it into the top corner. Sumptuous stuff. What about Bukayo Saka looking like a generational talent right now? He is so good. And those first 5-10 minutes, he could have scored a hat trick.
He's the first one. I thought it was in, obviously. The second one, obviously, just unlucky. It's just that kid is doing so much wonders for this team now. If it weren't for him, and I know people at the moment think it'd be a bit stressful to be a bit harsh on Leno because obviously he was a stupid today, but that keeper has done a lot as well. You know, But you know, it's stupid from him today. I can't lie. I'm a goalkeeper myself, and from there, I know reactions and stuff about coming out, but you just don't come out. I thought he was going to head the ball, to be honest, but it's just, you know,
it just makes no sense. I don't know. The only thing that I can think that could excuse it slightly is that the ball just kind of skidded onto him like earlier than he anticipated. But apart from that, it just looks like he's like trying to punch the ball. Like, you're 10 meters outside the box, bro. Yeah, what are you doing?
Definitely. it's like a reaction, exactly.
Absolute madness. Go on, hit me.
Okay, I just want to say to all the United fans as well out there, obviously, yeah, well done. You got your nine goals, yeah, so what? You got your defence, though, you know? You're saying, like, all best in... Your defence, you've got a bunch of fridges. You got a bunch of fridges at the back, you know? Maybe Wan-Bissaka's all right, you know? Like, don't start bigging your team up just because you're going on a bit of a glory game. Like, it's Ole for you. It's Ole for you, you know?
Big shots. You got to tell him. You got to put him straight. Yeah.
Exactly. That's what we're here for. We're only Arsenal fans here.
Indeed. Listen, lovely to speak to you, mate, Josh.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Do come on again. I will be.
No worries.
Yeah, it'd be fantastic to have you on again, especially after Arsenal actually do something that we can celebrate.
Oh, can't wait.
Ah, dear. We live, we move. Yeah, take care of yourself, mate. I'll speak to you soon. Josh Grant, massive fraud in the building, and there have been plenty of frauds in the building tonight. Much love to all of you who have got involved in the show. You're all massively fraudulent and hugely appreciated. Don't forget, I'm back here every day with more football content. In fact, more non-football content as well, because we are going to be doing some mukbangs. Yes, indeed. I know it sounds funny saying it, doesn't it? But I'm actually going to be doing some mukbangs and some other forms of content videos as well. There's also the podcast to check out, so please do go and check that out. I'm putting a lot of effort, time and money into it, so it'd be great if you could. But for now, I am going to love you and leave you. Massively appreciated if you have tuned in. You're all sexual frauds. For now, though, I've been Hugh Izzy, and this has been a lot of fun. Peace, guys. Exercise those freeloading fraudulent thumbs sooner, you massive frauds. I'll be on Twitch playing computer games in about an hour. Alright, peace, guys. Let me talk!